When you are finished with your project, the last step is to export or share your project. To start, navigate to the Final Cut Pro menu and select Preferences. Check the Destinations tab. This will list the default export options that will be available to you when you are ready to share your project. Most of the default export presets are either for services or devices, such as burning a DVD, exporting for an Apple device, or sending your video content directly to YouTube. If you need an additional preset, just drag it into the Destinations column. A good preset to have that's not a default is to Save Current Frame Preset. Each preset has its own settings. So for this particular preset, I'll choose Export as a JPEG image. Close the dialog box when you're finished. Okay, so now it's time to share your project. To do this, click in the timeline area to make sure your project is selected. Then navigate to the File menu and select Share. Within the Share menu, you will see the available export presets. To export to an Apple device, such as an iPhone or iPad, select one of the Apple device presets. A dialog box will appear. Park over the monitor icon in the lower right to see a list of compatible Apple devices for the preset you've selected. Then press the Share button to create the movie file. By default, this will automatically add the movie to your iTunes library, which can then be synced with your Apple device. Okay, now, if you need to export a master QuickTime media file, navigate back to the Share menu and choose Master File. If you click on the Settings tab, you can change whether or not you want to export video and/or just audio. You can also change the video codec that's wrapped within the QuickTime movie. Notice how you can also scrub through the preview window to view the content that's about to be exported. If you have a range selected within your project, Final Cut Pro 10 will only export that range. It will also export any connected clips within the area selected. Press the Next button to specify a location for your final QuickTime movie. That's it! You should now have the basics for using the Share function.